नीलातुङ्गस्तनगिरितटी सुप्तमुद्बोध्य कृष्णं पारार्थ्यं स्वं श्रुतिशतशिरःसिद्धमध्यापयन्ति स्वोच्छिष्टायां स्रजनिगळितं याबलात्कृत्य भुङ्क्ते गोदा तस्यै नमिदमिदं भूय एवास्तु भूयः। जय श्रीमन्नारायण। प्रिय भगवद्बन्धु, धनुर्मास इज ए वेरी पायस एंड ए सात्विक ऑस्टेरिटी, ए वेरी ग्रेट व्रतम द वर्ल्ड नोज एवर परफॉर्म्ड बाय गोदा देवी अप्रॉक्सिमेटली 5000 इयर्स अगो। इट्स बीइंग ऑब्जर्व्ड बाय millions of devotees across the world. It is because those who perform this Dhanurmasa Vratam are so generous, are so dedicated. Dhanurmasa Vratam is the one which blesses everybody with not only the worldly riches, but also with the divine wealth, the divine abode itself. Because the mantra they use while performing this vratam is Narayana mantra. Then what is the greatness of this mantra? Normally, when we perform some rituals which are pretty much mundane, even they also yield some kind of result. No matter what you do, whether it is a smaller one, a bigger one, or any size of the vratam, any size of activity, whenever it is done, will be resulting to some kind of fruit. That's for sure. Common people do that activity aiming at the fruit, but a real devotee of Lord Narayana, a real devotee of Lord Krishna will never do any activity aiming at the fruit. The aim of that devotee is always serving the Lord with love. When they serve, they don't expect anything. For sure, result will be there. Some fruit will also be there. But because they are not expecting anything, the fruit that is yielded will be distributed to everybody around the world. The people who do the activity are few, but the enjoyers of the fruit is the entire world. That's the beauty of this Dhanurmasa Vratam. Though the world knows it or not, but it is the way that devotees always do the service to the Lord. So also this Dhanurmasam. In fact, it is the Dhanurmasa that showed this tradition to the world. Godadevi did it first. She was doing this vratam for the sake of Lord Krishna's grace. She needs only the grace of Lord Krishna. What happens if the vratam is done? Because the one who is worshipped through this vratam is Lord Narayana, and the mantra they use in this vratam is Astakshari. Wherever the Astakshari Mahamantra is chanted with sincere devotion, that gives all sorts of benefits. The great sages say, Yatra Astakshara Samsiddha Mahabhagaha mahiyate. Wherever a devotee who dedicated himself or oneself to this mantra is staying, what happens? Na tatra sancharishyanti vyadhi durbhikra taskaraha. There won't be any kind of problems with these things. What are they? Vyadhi. They'll be freed from the diseases. That means their immunity becomes exponential. Very much needed, isn't it, nowadays? So, this Astakshri Mahamantra enhances one's own ability to resist with any kind of natural forces. So, Vyadhi, the diseases, will be away from such people. Not only from such people, from the surroundings wherever they stay. Durbhiksha, there'll be no disasters, natural disasters, natural calamities won't affect such people and also the areas where such people stay. There won't be any kind of droughts, basically. Drought won't be there. Taskaraha, and there won't be any kind of robberies and thefts. Such things will be eliminated from those areas by the grace of God. It's not just, you know, the mundane or the worldly stuff, but it is also like inner diseases, like arrogance and ego-like things will not be there if one follows the mantra. And then there won't be any dearth of knowledge. Proper and sufficient knowledge will be obtained by those people who follow the Mahamantra, Narayana Mahamantra, Astakshari. And there won't be any kind of, you know, robbers. What is the robbery? The biggest robbery is thinking oneself as an independent guy. All the souls belong to the Lord. Every soul, no matter who they are and where they are, but all the souls belongs to only the one, Patim Visvasyatmeswarakam Syasvatagam Sivamachyutam. The Veda declared, every soul belongs to Lord Narayana. What is that happening in this world? Is people think, no, I am by myself. I need not, you know, think of him at all. I need not do anything for him at all. What happening? The one, the soul that belongs to the Lord Narayana is being captured by those people. That is a theft. That is a robbery. If it is a small thing, then we call it a theft, or snatching or cheating. But if it's the most valuable thing and the most powerful stuff of this world, that becomes a robbery. Soul is a highly powerful one and invaluable stuff. And if that soul itself is, you know, snatched, that means thinking oneself as, I'm by myself. I need not believe anybody. I need not, you know, do anything for the sake of anybody. Declaring oneself independent itself is the biggest robbery. So, when one understands the mantra Narayana, they will be able to realize that the soul belongs to the Lord and everything is done by Him, and oneself, the results of all the activities, is just serving that Lord Narayana. not only the person who knows and who chants the Narayana mantra, but because of his grace, because of such a person's impact on the surroundings, the people in and around him also will be free from such kind of robbery. This has been proved in Mahabharata. Pandavas, we know very well, they are strong devotees of Lord Krishna, and their mantra to chant was Narayana Mahamantra. Because of their presence in Virat Nagar, when they were staying there for 1 year after their 12 years of exile is completed, that place, that city and the surroundings were enjoying tremendous peace and joy with tranquility. This is what the CIDs of Duryodhana found, and that's how they wanted the Uttara Gograhanam to take place to bring out Pandavas. So the Astakshaya Mahamantra was really very, very, very powerful, and that is the mantra what Godadevi has taken as support to perform this vrata. That means wherever Dhanurmasa Vratam is conducted and whoever chants this Narayana Mahamantra, they are contributing a lot to their surroundings, like peace, wealth, knowledge, and what you call that is obedience. So the people live in peace in such areas. So Godadevi declares that, and then for the vratam they perform, for the activities they do, because they never expect, they keep on just dedicating everything to the people around. That has been declared in third Pasuram of Tiruppavai by Godadevi. And how the benefit comes to the people is what she sung in her song, Ongi. We discussed about the previous activities done before this. Godadevi assembled all the gopikas, and they wanted to know what is the vratam is all about. Godadevi sung in first song and explained to all of them. When they wanted to know what are the do's and don'ts for this vratam, Godadevi just gave them all in the second song. And when they asked, what are we going to get when we perform this vratam? Godadevi sings the third song and explaining to them the fruits of the vratam if it is sincerely and seriously conducted. It was really conducted by gopikas. Godadevi imitated that for 1 month. They did for 1 day. Godadevi did it for 1 month, and she got a better fruit than what the gopikas got. And if we perform it as our life mission, for sure we get far better fruit than what Godadevi got. Yes. And when gopikas did, probably only they got the grace of Lord Krishna. But when Godadevi did it after that, and we are getting the grace of Lord Krishna all through the world. Remember, if we perform this vratam just imitating Godadevi, and the fruit that comes will definitely add a lot of good to the entire world. Yes? Let's understand what the fruit would be, how it would be in third song, Let us first of all sing the third song of Tiruppavai. Aandaal Tiruvadigale Saranam Ongi Ulagalanda Uttaman Per Padi Nangal Nampavai Kachati Niradinal Tinginni Nadellam Tingal Mummari Peidu Ongu Perum Senneludu Kayelugala Punkuvalai Podil Porivandu Kanpaduppa Tengade Puku Irundu Sirtha Mulai Patti Vanga Kudam Niraikkum Vallal Perum Pasukkal Neengada Selvam Niraindu Elorembavai. This is the beautiful song. So beautiful song it is. What we need to observe in this song is the power of Goda Devi's observation. Those who believe in Vedas, those who believe in Vedanta, those who believe in the Lord Narayana or Krishna, they never hate the nature. They never say, oh, all this is something Maya and we have to just, you know, give it up and, you know, go to Himalayas or somewhere else. Like, they never say that. Because the nature we live in, the objects we see all around in this nature, all this is the divine form of that Lord Himself, as He declared in the 10th chapter of Bhagavad Gita. At the end of the chapter, He also declared, Yad Yad Vibhuti Mat Sattvam Srimat Urjitame Bhava Tatta Deva Avagachatvam Mamatejum Se Sambhavam. Hey Arjun, whatever you see, the most beautiful stuff in this world, wherever it may be, and that beauty is just because of my grace and not the entire grace. A speck of my grace makes those things to become such a magnanimous and great things. This is what He declared. And the whole Veda says, you know, all this is His divine body. And even their sages declared, Jagat Sarvam Sariram Te. If the entire universe is divine form or divine body, do you hate God? Do you hate His body? Or do you really say, if you are a Vedanti, if you really believe in Vedas and the sages, do you say, oh God, I love you so much, but I hate your body? Is it okay? No, that never happens. Because you see the soul through the body only. You do anything to the soul through body only. And if Lord Narayana is the soul, and if the entire universe is divine body, and you have to do anything through this body only to Him, and you need to appreciate that every part of this universe is nothing but His divine form. And if you are able to look at it, if you are able to connect everything to Him, then that becomes divine. That never becomes Maya. It never becomes illusionary. And Goda Devi, so great, and her observation and her understanding the nature is impeccable. we need to see that in every part of Tiruppavai. And we can really, you know, overwhelmed with the joy how she is able to. And even that at her age of, you know, probably 8 or 9 years. This is what inspired our great Acharya Ramanuja to give his philosophy of beauty, Saundarya Siddhanta, what we call the Visishta Advaita Siddhanta as Saundarya Darshanam, we call it. How he was able to do that? Because he was always worshipping Goda Devi, and whatever her vision was really understood by the great Acharya Ramanuja Swami. That we can start tasting in the third song itself. And here is that. Goda Devi invited all the gopikas, and when they asked, hey, what will be the result of the vratam if we really do it? Then Goda Devi says, look, we are doing a very small thing, but the benefit is so unimaginable. That is because we are surrendering to the natural supporter and eternal supporter of the soul, Lord Narayana. So the benefits also are eternal, like him, because he blesses anything as per his capability, as per his ability. And what is he then? He is Trivikrama. Trivikrama, the one who measured all the worlds. When he became Trivikrama from Vamana, we know the story. He became Vamana, a dwarf-like, when Bali the king grabbed the kingdom of Indra. Both were brothers. Certain, you know, the properties were given to both of them by the Lord himself. But Bali was a little bit powerful with muscles, and Indra probably maybe a little bit weak. And so he, out of his arrogance, just kicked off Indra and took away his property and started enjoying. Indra cried, and he approached the Lord Narayana and sought for help. Okay, God wanted to tell even Bali also, Magrutaha kasya svidhanam, don't covet the wealth of others. Don't be covetous. He wanted to teach that. But if it was a demon, then he would have just finished him. But Bali was such a great person, very, very charitable, gives away anything anybody asks. So because he is able to give, let me become someone to just beg from him. And if it happens that way, finish. Our job is over and becomes ease. So he became a small dwarf like Vamana and went to him and asked for just 3 feet of land as per his own foot condition. And then he requested Bali, and Bali accepted that and gave away with water. And immediately out of joy, this boy grew up, expanded himself to the size of the entire universe. And with one he measured the earth, with the second he measured the space, and with the third he measured Bali himself. And then gave Indra's portion to Indra. But because Bali was great, charitable, he wanted him to be in a position where he will be able to do the best possible. So took him to a place called Rasatala, and made him the ruler of Rasatala. Because he was so generous and accepted his request, the Lord himself surrendered to him to be his security officer. God became the security officer of Mahabali. And he was there with him constantly, you know, just taking care. This is what we observe in Ramayana and other scriptures. Let it be. What happened? The Lord was so concerned for the feelings of others. If he's an arrogant guy, then he will teach the lesson. If he's a generous one, yes, he accommodates himself to the nature of that person. So Bali was so pleased with that nature and simply just give away everything. God is so great that way. He is not a very, very stubborn ruler. He was very, very lenient parent. Okay? He's very much concerned for us. We are doing our vratam for his sake. So our effort is very little. What do we need to do? Simply just sing his song, his name. Remember, when you are blessed with a nice tongue to chant something, select the name of someone who is really good and charitable. Don't let the tongue be polluted, you know, by touching the names and things which are not supposed to be touched. Let it be purified with the name of such kind of Lord who is Uttama. He is Uttama, so your tongue also becomes Uttama when you touch his name with the tongue. In Bhagavad Gita, 15th chapter, he declared himself as Purushottama, Uttama Purusha. This is what Gotadevi sings today. He became Uttama Purusha because he is the one supports all the other Purushas, no matter whether they are humans, animals, birds, trees and plants, devatas, rakshasas or asuras, or let them fall in any category of all these things, but he supports all of them. And he wants everyone should be promoted for higher ranks. That's why he, with no expectations from others, then he does all these things. So he became Uttama Purusha, Purushottama. Let us chant his name. And what did he do? Just, you know, to satisfy the ego of Bali, he became a beggar. And then when he sanctioned that, Bali sanctioned that, his joy was, you know, his joy knew no bounds. So he just expanded. That is the greatness of such people. They do, they feel joy in doing. Ongi. Ongi, just growing. What did he do by growing? Ulagu alanda. He measured the entire earth. In this third song, Godadevi thinks of this Trivikrama and his activity of measuring the earth only. But again, in 17th song, she talks about his measuring the space. And again in 24th song, the third foot, measuring the self. That's what she talks about. But now, the first activity he did was just measuring the earth. Ulagalanda, why did he measure? not for his sake, not for the sake of name or fame, not able to see the pain of others, and to teach a lesson to those who are crossing their limits. Just that. Nobody, in fact, recognized him during that time, but still he was happy because he did what is supposed to be done. Jai Sri Manarayana.